G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and this is part 5 in the series of calculating wall bracing, and this time we're looking at the nominal bracing from wind direction 2. So continuing on from the last video, this time we're going to look at wind direction 2, which is over here blowing against this side of the building. So it's blowing against this wall, so the walls running in the same direction as the wind are the ones that are actually going to resist the load. So firstly, we're going to look at walls sheeted on one side only. So we've got this wall here, which is 14 metres, 840 long. I'll take off 0.48, which is the cavity and the brickwork. Take that off twice, okay, for both ends. And then what I've done is I've just taken away all the window openings. So I've just added them up. That came to 8.55. So I take all that away, I get effectively 5.8 metres from this wall. And if I go to wall 2, I get 6.8 metres out of this wall. That I have effective wall space or wall size to use. So that's minusing all my windows, and it's minusing any panels that would be less than 450 mil long, because we can't use those. So that gives me a total length of those walls of 12.120 metres. And we times that by our bracing capacity for nominal bracing, single-sided, which is 0.45, gives me 5.45 kilonewtons of bracing in wind direction 2 for single-sided. If we go to double-sided walls, so wall 1, total of 5 metres, I've taken away 900 for both doors, gives me 3.5 metres effective bracing there. And then wall 2, which is a longer one here, 11.14 metres long, taken away 2.7 for all the doorways, gives me an effective area of or length of 8.44. Add them together, times it by the bracing capacity for double-sided walls, gives me 8.955 kilonewtons of resistance in that direction. So add them together, and I get 14.409 kilonewtons of resistance acting on wind direction 2. Okay, so we know, if you look at wind direction 2, we originally needed 20.254 kilonewtons of resistance. Our bracing is actually going to give us, nominal bracing is going to give us 14.409, which is more than half of that. And remember, we can only use nominal bracing for 50%, okay? So instead of just minusing that, all we can really do is take our 20.254, divide that by 2, so we have 10.127 kilonewtons of bracing still required in wind direction 2. Okay, so now we've worked out the nominal bracing, we now know how much actual bracing we need to add into the building, and that's what I'll look at in the next video. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.